24-hour fitness.
Chest, right?
Chest. Chest day. Every day. And yeah, Frank couldn't make it, so just me and the champion, Han champion, and Goku champion in the house. It's not your normal PVC pipe.
It works.
It's the big one. It's like Han likes it.
That's what she said.
Han was 99 double Dutch Olympic champion for Vietnam. Nah, I'm just kidding, but this is what he does to warm up. He plays with the rope.
Get that blood pumping.
There we go. There you go. Double. Oh shit. Not bad.
Hang on, I haven't jumped rope in so long. Ow.
Battle scars. That's what the jump rope did.
Dude, we're just warming up.
Now warming up the upper body. Some push-ups off the bench. I like doing actually push-ups. Push-ups. Push-ups off the bench. Because it also warms up your elbows. I have tricep tendonitis, so I notice it warms up the elbows and the triceps nice. Also, when you're doing this exercise, or when you're warming up like this, focus on the chest contraction. So trying to build that mind-muscle connection before you even start the bench. So I'm coming up, squeezing my chest at the top.
I just pretend I'm humping.
Look who's here. What's your name, man?
Juan? Yup.
Nice. You just started watching my channel. What do you think of my channel?
It's good, man. I like it. Positive vibe.
Positive vibe? Yeah, it looks like you're killing it, man.
Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah, what are you getting? What are you hitting?
Back? Yeah,
look at that. You're sweating, man. It's killing it.
Yup.
Hey, keep it up, man. I'll let you get back to your workout. Hey, nice to see you. What's up, man? Warm up with the bar. Damn, that tuck. That hip mobility. Getting those legs underneath those hips. There you go.
I watch your videos.
Hey, what's up, man?
Nice to meet you.
Hey, what's your name?
I'm Andy.
Andy?
Yeah, nice. I watch your channel.
Yeah? You want to say what's up to them? I was actually just filming.
Cool. What are you doing in Cali?
We're here for
see how you do when we load some weights.
Yeah, so as you guys know, I rarely flat bench, so that's why I went to flat bench with Han. For you guys don't know, Han benches, what, 450? 455 was his max bench. So we're gonna practice today. We're gonna practice. Even though I like incline better.
Practice makes perfect.
Yes, sir. 5 pounds on the bar. One of the most common injuries I see is people lifting too heavy when they're cold.
Like, I did 405 here, cold, like a few years ago.
And you hurt yourself?
No, I felt like shit the next day.
Oh. Yeah, so we're just warming up nice and light. So even Han, a 450 bencher, still warms up nice and slow. Set up, tuck, arch the back, pinch the shoulder blades down, keep those shoulders in a nice healthy position, bring the bar straight down, push it straight back. There you go. See how he's nice and tight the whole way? His legs are staying nice and tight. Ass on the bench. Shoulder blades back.
Like extending all the way back here, like you're doing.
I see what you're saying. Right? reps I make in.
So you're using all your energy just taking off. But this one, keep your eye level. That way it's just minimum. Just move it there. Boom, you're ready to go. Or otherwise, if you're too far up, you're gonna end up hitting the
rack.
Rack, so.
Yeah, so eye level's about perfect.
Yeah, just give it a try.
All right, cool.
Spot. The first one, Matt's never worked out with me before, so he doesn't know how I like to lift. I don't really know how he likes to lift. So all these collabs, it's really hard to work with people. It's when you train with somebody, you start to know how they lift and how much they can lift, or how they like things, or when they're about to give out, you need to save them.
Yeah.
It's important to pay attention. For the first handoff, he had it way out too far, and the second one was just perfect. Just hand it out. Just right there.
So it's just about learning how your partner lifts and just adapting to it, and telling your spotter up front, especially if you ask like a random spotter at the gym.
Yeah, I don't
tell them up front like how you want it.
Three. Good. Rest.
What are you doing next?
So the next set here, street 15. I'll probably try to go five and do some pauses here. It's a good weight that I can work with today, because last night we only had like a few hours of sleep, maybe two at most.
Yeah, we just flew in this morning.
Last night, so a lot of heavy weights, deadlifts, heavy dumbbell presses, weighted pull-ups, so my whole body's pretty beat. So, you know, it's one thing about training hard, and then it's also training smart so you don't get hurt.
Yeah.
Since we've been traveling all day, just sitting around on a plane, and, you know.
Gauging your body.
This is, just listening to your body. And this is the weight we're gonna work with today, just 315. I'm gonna try to hit like five, pause it a little bit, and we're gonna get Matt to hit two. The reason why we go low reps on here is that way you can focus on your form and your explosiveness out there. Because if you start trying to pump this out eight times, you're gonna get tired by, if you're not used to this weight, if you get tired by the fifth, you start getting sloppy. Start adapting to being sloppy.
That's why you snap it up.
Yeah, so the low reps, one, two, on your heavy sets really fixes your form and allows you to up the weight.
Especially pause reps. I noticed I can stay a lot tighter.
Yeah.
Yeah, it takes a little bit more technique too.
Knowing that you only have to do two reps, you focus on those two reps. Instead of like, oh, I'm going to rep out as many as I can.
Yeah.
You know, train hard, but have a solid plan.
Fun fact, I've never paused 315 ever. So, we're gonna do it today though.
A little bit. You can't use somebody else's position practice and the low reps. You figure out, okay, if I put my foot here, I got a little bit more power and drive through with my legs.
Yeah.
If I grip it here, I get more power through my triceps.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, and even when Han said he did the 345, he said he did it on his toes, when typically you've been on your heels, right? Oh, 455. Yeah, 455.
Yeah, my best lift, I did it on my toes, and it's better. Supposedly, it's better if you keep your foot flat and planted, but, you know.
So what works for you.
Yeah, I mean, I've seen guys that false grip in my place.
Yeah.
If it works, it works.
Yeah.
Dumbbells next. Another exercise I haven't done in ages. I'm going to be sore tomorrow just because all these exercises I haven't done in a long time.
Yeah. So I'm starting off with hundreds. Now I'm just going to pause them.
Hundreds. All right, cool.
Man, this bench is pretty high.
Yeah, it is high, right?
There you go. There you go. See, you gotta get your balance on this.
Oh, it's catching a cramp.
I started with the hundreds because I've been working with a bit heavier weight. Matt hasn't done flat in a while, so I'll just make a suggestion to start with the 80s. If you can do it, move up. You know, you don't want to jump too high and strain something.
Yeah.
Don't work with somebody else's weight. Work with what you have to work with.
120s on deck.
It's actually 125s.
125s? So notice how Han puts it right next to his hips, like you were telling me earlier.
So what you want to do, you keep it close to your body. And when you roll back with it, right in the middle, you can just press it up. And then you save your breath on the initial lift.
Okay.
It really
really helps. All right, yeah. Let's see it.
So when you cut off your air, like holding out the bottom,
yeah,
you get tired from that.
Okay. Yeah. So save a little energy.
Yeah.
All right.
And when you wrap up, you go real quick. So like, yeah, you're out.
All right, let's do it. So roll back and push up.
There you go. That's why I have it close.
Yeah, okay. Boom. Pause, boom. Explode. Pause, explode. Good. There you go. Come on, Han. Lightweight. Easy. Good. Come on. Nice. Explode. Explode. Good, Han.
So, one thing I want to talk about after you finish your set is bringing the weight down. After you're done with your last rep, before you bring it all the way down, kick your knees up, catch the weight, and then roll it up. So, pretend these knees are hundreds. So, this is my last rep. Last rep. As I bring it in, as you bring it down, lift your knees up, and use the momentum of the weights to catch. Make sure you don't Charlie horse your knee. I've done that a lot of times and it's really sore. You've probably done it too, right?
No.
You've never done it?
No.
Oh yeah, I've done it a lot of times. So you're gonna
if
push
I can't,
the weights out towards your knees, catch it, and use the momentum to stand you up.
If I don't have enough energy to do that, I just drop it on the side. I mean,
or just drop it, but watch out so you don't hit anyone.
As long as you're not
break anyone's toes or anything.
Easy. Touch your wrist in a little bit. There you go. Good. Easier?
Easy.
How'd that feel?
Better.
Yeah, if I keep my wrist out pretty straight?
I have a problem of keeping my wrist really straight and putting a lot of stress on the anterior delt instead of turning my pinkies down. And that's just years of lots of bro benching, how they teach you how to bench really wide.
Yeah,
but what it actually does is it puts a lot of pressure on the anterior delt. That's why you turn it down a little bit, takes the pressure off here, puts it on your triceps.
Turn down for what?
Turn down for triceps.
Really appreciate the loner shirt. You gotta keep it. It's
Han's
like super comfortable.
Wearing my shirt. like making me look bad in it too.
Here's the thing, man.
It's very well fitted. It's like the length is perfect. Usually you get a bigger shirt for bigger arms. Mm-hmm. It's really long, and, you know?
Yeah.
And this is like fitted to your body.
Yep.
And look at this sleeves. It's like super stretchy. It's super comfortable. It's not cutting off my circulation.
Yep.
And it's not choking my neck, because usually if you work out, your traps are big. Well, this is like perfect for someone that works out.
Yep. That's why I like my alpha clothes.
I really think this feels better than the stretchy Under Armours I have, so.
Yeah?
By far, this is one of the best shirts.
So, since you got it all sweaty and hand juice.
I'm just gonna auction it off.
I'm just giving it to him.
Thanks,
you're welcome.
Shirtless. Just
finished our workout. Han champion. Anyways, like this video if you guys want more tutorial videos featuring Han and I. Comment on things you'd like to see. And subscribe to Han. Let's get this Asian persuasion up to 100,000 subscribers. It only took him 5 years, even though he did work for only 2.
I have like 100 videos.
Anyways, see you guys in the next video. Strength and honor, much love. Aloha! Post-workout meal for the fatty.
Don't blow me.
Can you just take that up to his room?
Of course! Please. Take as many as you want.
Don't tell him that.
You're gonna help him eat it.
Look at... What?
Oh, thank you so much. That way I'm pretty white. Nothing's going to be.
What?
Oh, I love you. Thank you.
Don't encourage him.
Don't.
He's going to be doing
thank
this every
so
day now.
I'm so hungry.
Look at this guy.
Muscles. Dude, he has to feed those.
I know. This is why you're small.
Oh.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
This is why he's fat.
Vegeta, what does the scouter say about his power level? It's over 9,000! Immortal!